y'all. Welcome to No Fluff TV Conversations with the P. And I have my favorite.
Yay, I'm a favorite.
Return guest, Miss Shaterra. What's up with you? How you doing?
What's up? I'm doing good. Life is good. Can't complain. Won't complain, you know?
Yeah. So, the last time you were here was the late night series. We both had been indulging.
August. August, right?
Probably, yeah.
Okay.
After y'all had a lingerie party, you came over. You had Hennessy shots.
I really think it was 8-8. And because it was the Lions Gate or something. I think it was August the 8th. Yeah, y'all, but I'm back. Y'all here, yeah. I'm the favorite, so that means he got to keep bringing me on.
That's right.
Even when I get real big time and everybody be calling and booking me for interviews and stuff, I'm going to always come back and say that you're my favorite person to interview me. For real, P.
Yeah, yeah, that's fine.
When I do my homegoing, when I pass away, I want to, y'all got to do it big for me. I need y'all to do a nice, homegoing ceremony for me. And I want you to, I got a homegirl. I want the writer to put together a documentary for me, but I want you to interview people.
Or that'd be dope. Yeah, I love
my dying days. My last. That's what I want. That's my request.
That's fire. I like that.
The first person that gave me a real platform to do interviews and shit, and always made me feel so good to be up here. I always feel like somebody.
No, you are, because like I say, No Fluff TV is a platform for everyone. If they want the platform, really, because a lot of us, we come from these small beginnings and. A lot of times we have stories and things we want to tell and share, and we feel like, man, I wish I could be on Breakfast Club, or I wish I could be interviewed by Oprah or all these different people. You know what I'm saying? Just thinking, because we watch.
I'm trying to retrain my thinking, because literally first thing came to mind, I got to say, because there's Fluff TV, literally was fuck Oprah. That's why I made that face, but then I kind of bit my lip on it, because my grandma been watching my YouTube channel. She been watching the interviews with us, and she said I cuss a lot. I'm sorry, grandma.
Yeah, you really do, but I think it's,
it's the passion for
me. Yeah, I was about to say, it's I don't think it's just randomly cursing. I think it's it's
in the moment. Serious.
Yeah,
so in the moment. Fucking serious.
You really
see all
that.
The time. Right. So I'm just, grandma, you're going to have to charge it to the game. I love my grandma, though. Definitely shout out to Miss Sharon.
But yeah, man, I wanted to have a platform where everyone can feel like, man, I can go up, have my voice heard, by some people. And so that's why I wanted to have it. So that's why I'm happy to, have you on. And I'm glad to see that, you're not just, on my platform. You created your own.
See, you inspired me. Yeah. It was around that same time. You gave me really the courage to do it, because I had been contemplating on doing it for so long since, I'm into tarot and building that. I'm I want, for people to get easy access to me. What other way to do that other than YouTube?
That's dope. So what's the response been?
To what?
To your page and
creating
your channel.
YouTube?
Yeah.
I think it's been pretty good feedback. Mm-hmm. I'm not really too big on numbers and stuff right now. I'm not really. I really do it more so for my comfort. I really get it's me. Feel I be getting up there talking. It's me. It's my show. This is my shit. So I like it.
I mean, that's all that matters.
But I haven't got bad feedback. I do have people that comment. So it's dang, I didn't know y'all be watching. So I do. I get that feedback to myself. Oh damn, people really are watching me. But it's also girl, duh.
So you're not surprised by it. And I think
I am still surprised by it. That's the thing. Because I don't know who the views are. I don't know what's going on. I do appreciate being, watched and stuff. But it has everything to do with me. I do this for, my memories. I want, family and kids, everybody to be able to see, YouTube, keep everything.
Yeah. I thought about that, too. You're just talking about when you pass. I'm I'm sure when I'm passed, all my numbers are going to go up, because people are I missed it while he was here. Let me watch while he's gone, type thing. Mm-hmm. So, it's always something that people can go back and see,
You're right.
See what you've done. And you say your grandma was watching?
This is my mom's mom. And remember, when you think about it, he the first, and I got to go back and watch him, because I don't know if I ever really did. Because I'm going to stand on what I say. Whatever I said, that's what it was at the time.
Right.
But I can do an update. Me and my dad are talking. Because I remember the first time I came up here, it was a lot about you know, we talked about like childhood traumas and stuff. I was really big on that, still really big on that. But since then, I have been able to process some of the things that was in there. But I think that's what I, then I was moving and stuff. So that was around, yeah, it hadn't been around like August around that time.
So y'all started talking. So how did it begin? Like, he saw the video.
Well, you know, I sent him the link. I would always do stuff like, you know, and not even in a petty way, because I love my daddy, you know, and I said that in the video. I just was not a fan of his ways. And honestly, my people in the rear probably, I ain't going to say, still not the biggest fan of his ways. Like, I'm learning to just honestly process it different. But I I was like going to the job. I went to Edenton. This really happened. I went to Edenton and called his job because I wanted to take him some lunch.
Right.
And I'm like, shit, well, I don't know if he's going to text me back. So, shit, if I call the supervisor, and, you know, the supervisor, you know, kick him in the tail. So I called, you know, talked to the supervisor, and he actually made my dad let my dad call me back. And, you know, I just started doing little stuff. I would leave him crystals and stones in the mailbox, you know, send a text. Oh, I was still doing my part to communicate. I'm trying to figure out what happened. Oh, my grandma was... had to go to the hospital, his mom. And obviously, like, that was a concern. So I was like, okay, yeah, let me reach out to see how he doing and stuff. And we have been talking a little more consistent since then. So I'm like, okay.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah, because that's my daddy. I meet my daddy. That was my whole point of doing the video the first time. Like, I need a relationship with my daddy. I need a relationship with both my parents. A good one at that.
That's right.
You know, so, yeah. We working on it.
Yeah. And your mom...
Yeah.
She gave me a follow. I appreciate it.
She did. Yeah, my mom is very supportive. Appreciate she that. Is, definitely. She gonna support the team. She gonna support. And one thing I can say about her, even if it's not really... She has a balance. I'm gonna say, even if it's something she's not really the biggest fan of, she supports it. But I feel like that's more so with me. But then it's kind of like, no, because she's not really into the whole spiritual shit, the stuff I be doing. But I'm saying, I think she obviously understands the... I'm her daughter. Like, she know who she raised. So, I think she's more so supportive of what I'm doing. Because she, like, she know I got good intentions and, like, you know, stuff like that. So, my mama know me.
Right.
So, definitely my mama daughter.
Right. So, you know, other than, you know, what we've, you know, heard as far as your relationship with your pops and that, you know, has gotten better. What other challenges have you seen just throughout this year? Because, I mean, you know, 2020 has been a rocky road for, you know, a whole lot of people. So, like, what challenges have you seen and overcome this year?
Balance. That was something that was a really, really thing, a really big thing for me that I had to work on, because I realized that I was a really, like, all or nothing person. I think that's the Aries in me, like, just super loyal. It's kind of like... this way or that, like, it's no in between. Well, it was no in between. However, but recently I am realizing that I need to have a lot of balance, and with balance comes, like, you know, seeing the underlying in between. So that's been a challenge for me. I didn't, because for one, I didn't even realize that I was having an all or nothing mindset, or, like, you know, pattern traits or none of that. But when I did, it was kind of like, for one, it was hard to face that. Cause it was like, no, I don't really. Because you know how it is when you gotta critique yourself. It'd be like, is this really a thing? But no, it was really a thing. So, yeah, just finding a balance to keep going. School is definitely something I had to keep pushing through. I'm still pushing through with it. Almost done. So, yeah, just finding a balance. Work, business, social life, you know, all that good stuff. Definitely balance.
So what made you acknowledge that? What made you see, like, okay, I'm in balance on so many things?
School. Okay. Shout out to my program at school. It enables me to be very self-aware. It helps me with my self-awareness so much. I think I mentioned that before. My program has a lot to do with me just opening up and realizing a lot about myself. And, yeah, I was doing, like, a supervision meeting with one of my professors, and she is amazing. She is really heaven sent. And it was like, okay. And she reads me. You know, it takes a lot to read a sister like me. But I appreciate her. Her name is Dr. Williams, and she be out here watching. She know. But it's so funny because, yeah, she's African-American female. She from around the way. She's actually from, like, Jamesville.
Really? Okay.
Right. But she moved, like, when she got the job, she was, like, you know, coming from Chicago or something like that. So, you right. know, we find out that we're from the same place, and she's a Williams. So, I'm like, right, wow. God sent you here for me at this right. program, sis. Right, like, right, you right. cannot tell me no difference. So, right. definitely, one of my top three most influential women in life. Like, okay. literally, like, right. in life. So, I, it was her. She brought a lot of self-awareness to me. In a way that it was kind of like, oh, that explains why I feel so off. Because I couldn't really put a finger on why I was feeling so damn near burnt out.
Mm-hmm.
So that had a lot to do with it. This is a level up phase, and this level up requires some balance. Because I need to be equipped. Like, you know, I need to be okay mentally and, like, you right. know, spiritually, emotionally, and stuff like that. So, right. yeah, that was really helpful for me. My program and my supervision okay. woke me up a lot.
So you said top three people that, who inspire you, and I know your mom is one. The other one, right? If I'm not mistaken, let me know. I mean,
no, I did. But it was okay. Like,
I remember you saying your mom.
Yeah, yeah. definitely. Yeah, most influential. And you got to think like this. Yeah, my mom was definitely top three most influential. I would probably say.
The third is.
Who would be a third? Paris. My cousin Paris.
Okay.
Okay. She a Williams.
Okay. Yeah, I don't know Paris, but shout out to you, Paris.
Yeah, shout out to my fave. Okay. That's but you know how that be. So our moms are sisters.
Okay.
And she's a cancer woman. I told y'all I need my cancer women. Cancer right. males kinda like skirt. However, but on the connecting level, on the romantic right, right. tip, but cool no. as hell, P. You know you're my favorite cancer right. male. But Paris is my yeah, that's my cousin. So she's had a really major impact on me, like mm-hmm. on a growing level.
Okay, so yeah, that's dope. So what else inspires you, like, to make you continue to push forward, continue to stay motivated, to want to create balance in your life? What else is inspiring you to keep, you know, rising?
My
achieving.
Kids.
Your kids.
Yeah.
Okay.
My kids, my legacy, the stuff that I don't have for right. real, for real, Pete. That's right. really it. Yeah. It's because it's like, who else are you doing it for? Like, you know, we getting older. We, mm-hmm. you know, we obviously perish away. It's kind of like,
true.
How am I really leaving a legacy if I'm going to die and it's just me?
Right.
You know? So, yeah, I honestly think I start to think about stuff like that more. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, starting a family, having kids and stuff. So it's kind of like, right. yeah, y'all, Shaterra going to slow down.
Right.
Somebody going to tame this little Aries one day and I'm going to chill.
Yeah, good luck with y'all, you know.
Good fucking luck, bro.
Yeah, right.
The best. May the best man win.
Right, please. Right, right.
We're going to have to come back and talk about that. Because yeah. when you see me out here... You know, coupled up. I know P gonna be like, yeah.
I'm gonna
who
be
is
shocked.
This?
Yeah,
I'm gonna be shocked. Like, who make the cut, Spirit? Who is it?
Yeah, I'm like, yo, you okay?
You know, he gotta be a different breed, though.
Right. I'm gonna just check on him. Just like, are you okay? Do you need to talk?
No, he gonna be great though. That's
okay.
the thing, though.
He gonna, yeah. Okay. He can handle it.
Yeah, that's okay. that's the only way it's gonna be a thing.
That's the only way it's gonna be a thing.
I gotta be accepted out
right.
here.
Right.
The real me, the whole me, you right. know. All of me.
All of you.
Yeah.
The good, the bad, and the ugly. Okay.
And it don't get too ugly around
yeah.
here.
Right.
It don't.
Okay.
Mm-mm.
So, you got something to look forward to, brother.
Amazing.
And she got the, you know, the lingerie already, too.
That ain't got nothing to do with y'all.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry.
Nothing. But y'all can't go shop, though, for y'all ladies.
Go shop. Are you happy that I got a new box?
And yeah, I was trying to. I was actually like kept looking at the numbers. I thought it was 888, but it's 858. That's mm-hmm. cool too, though.
Yeah. So yeah, as what happens is like, this is a humidor, and so like when I was getting into cigars, it was like, I'm like, what is this? But I had to keep learning, do some education. I was like, oh, it's just a humidor. So I'm like, oh, I just use this box. So
this is what they put cigars in.
Yeah, when they started cigars. Keep them fresh. But I just like it, you know what I mean?
Seems like yeah, a very sturdy, reliable yeah. box.
Yeah. Yeah,
y'all, because I did say, so I'm like, Pete, what is this? What
you yeah, relax.
Bucket?
I mean,
what
hey.
You had, what
it
you
was a little name? Box. A little box I had, you know.
That some, like, business cards or something come in.
It had the car mount thing.
Definitely, y'all, a little box.
Man, whatever, but... The question's still fire in here. We don't even, I ain't mess with you with those questions. But this, That's for something else.
I don't need December. The questions.
No, we're not doing no questions. Mm-hmm. So, like, what are the holidays like for you? Like, how was Thanksgiving? Or do you participate?
I participate in life, so...
Okay.
You know, Thanksgiving and Christmas and all this stuff is definitely around.
Okay.
Thanksgiving was good, though.
What did you cook?
I did not cook anything. Yeah.
Come on, Shaterra.
No, I ain't cook nothing.
Nothing. No greens, no green beans, no mac and cheese, none of that.
What did I do? I actually went to a Friendsgiving. We were supposed to do like a family thing, and I actually got invited to my homegirl house.
Right.
And that was good.
Who cooked? They cooked their ass off. Oh, really?
Yep. Shout out to Raven and Witt and Isha. Her sister Isha came. And it was a good time. It was only like 4 or 5 of us, her niece. It was a good time.
Yeah, a little small.
Something small,
So what's the plans for like Christmas and everything?
For Christmas, I just look forward to seeing the Christmas lights. I do get excited about that. I do like to drive around, you know, like the big neighborhoods and shit like that. Mm-hmm. So
some big houses. Yeah, some nice neighborhoods over here. I'm like, yo.
They got lights out.
Lights. Yo, they got the whole...
I need to go check them out. Because I do like stuff like that to find like Christmas trails and stuff. I'm not really like the most, I guess, religious person. Right. But I do like the energy. I just like to see people happy. So I really think that's what Christmas does for me. Yeah, like everybody else good. So it's like, if this is what y'all need to feel good, I'm here for it. I embrace it.
But
I do get excited by the lights and stuff like that.
So like, what are you planning to do for Christmas? Are you going to be...
Trying to get flued out.
Okay. When are you going to Turks and Caicos?
I wish.
Hawaii somewhere?
Whatever. I got a passport, so I really can get flued out wherever. Wherever they're trying to fly me out at, and the energy good.
Hey, what if they're trying to make you put on, take that vaccine, though?
Wouldn't dare.
They might start requiring that. I just seen it today. They might start requiring the vaccine. To do international travel. That's crazy. Something to think about, though.
No, it's not.
Okay. So you're just going to be like, nah.
I don't entertain thoughts like that.
Right.
It's not a part of my life path.
Right.
Spirit know how I feel about stuff like this and know that it's in my desire to travel internationally. So that's what the fuck is going to happen.
Okay.
Yeah, I can't entertain thoughts like that because they don't line up. You get what I'm saying? It's not compatible. It don't work like that.
Okay.
But I appreciate you saying that. I mean, because I really don't keep up with stuff like that. I don't.
I kind of just see out because I don't watch the news. And I just kind of
I'm not surprised. They always trying to make us do something.
Yeah.
But we ain't about to talk about that, y'all. I don't like to talk about stuff like that to people.
I'm about to go back to Christmas.
I'm
about to go back to Christmas because I don't really want to get into all that conspiracy stuff.
We ain't about to do all that.
But what's the best Christmas song ever, though?
I like the Mariah Carey, All I Want for Christmas.
Come on, please.
That's the classic.
I mean, it is. It's like when you hear it, you think of Christmas, but from a corporate standpoint. Not like real Christmas. Not like...
Now you got to tell me your definitions of real Christmas. When I say real Christmas,
meaning like, you know, what you hear at your mom and daddy house or your grandma house.
That's what I'm hearing at my mom and daddy house.
Not when you go into Walmart and you hear, you know, Mariah Carey singing All I Want for Christmas. This is to get you to shop. I'm talking about the Christmas where... You know.
So now I'm about to tell y'all exactly what he's trying to do. He's trying to make his Christmas experience my Christmas.
No, I'm not saying. I'm just saying the black people Christmas, like, you know, where your mom and them they fixing the yams and all that. They, you know, they wrapping gifts, trying to hide it from the kids. You know, that type of Christmas. Not like I'm in the store shopping. I'm talking about like Temptations.
See, why Mariah Carey want to know? He asked me what was the first thing. But I mean, I get what you're saying. I mean, those Christmas songs okay, too. I mean, I'm definitely here for the culture Christmas. You know, definitely got to have them tunes, that soul in it. You know?
Yeah, I'm just saying, like, This Christmas by Donny Hathaway. Come on, man. It's classic.
How old are you? Because definitely, man. Age difference.
But still, though, that's like, you know, Christmas songs. They don't really make a whole bunch of new Christmas songs.
But then when you think about it, who created them Christmas songs?
I don't even know.
Because didn't we just remake them for real?
Some of them, yeah.
Like, they keep it high. Like, a lot of those like, are remade. But I like that, though. I'm okay with that. Like, I feel like that's a part of life. Everything is recreated and reused and stuff like that. But that's the first one that came to mind.
Yeah, I do like that one.
I mean, because if it's around the house Christmas time, like, we playing whatever we want to play.
Right.
Like, it's not even necessarily Christmas music. Like, my mama is a fan of Mary J. Blige, so it might have been, you know, some area or something, you know, some reggae or some gospel, but it's not always technically Christmas music.
Okay, I got you. So when does it feel like Christmas to you? Like what time? It's like, you know, is it like a certain movie come on TV, like Charlie Brown Thanksgiving? And a Charlie Brown Christmas, or is it like...
That's a good question. When does it start to feel like... I guess when people start talking about it.
Yeah. Yeah, because I don't know why it's like a good, you know, feeling, but I don't know if it's just nostalgic. Because of what you're, you know, used to.
It's really not it's not the best feeling for me. I can think of a lot of other things. I think...
Okay.
It has a lot to do with... Again, I like to see people happy. Like, I feel, and then the thing is, really why I don't fuck with Christmas like that, because people is not really happy. Like,
right.
Bro, when I tell you people is stressed out about impressing people and doing all that, and it just really irks me.
Right.
But I try to think about what the real, I be thinking about, I try to go to my childhood, like Santa, like giving people stuff and not being stressed out, because I don't feel like that's a fair trade. Like,
right.
So you mean to tell me in order to give, I got to be stressed out and knowing that it's not a good fitting situation for me.
Right, right.
But the most is definitely the lights for me. It's the lights, the scenery, the snow, the, you know.
Yeah.
All that.
I think it should just be, I mean, I can't say should be, but I say for me it's more just like family time. You know what I mean? So, you know, spend time with your family, have fun, eat good.
Definitely ready for that Thanksgiving part two with the food, though.
I mean,
that's how I always looked at Christmas, like the
Christmas
meal jumping.
Right,
like,
yeah,
need that Thanksgiving
part
two.
But I don't really want that no more. Like, want something like had the Thanksgiving style food. I don't really want it no more.
Well, it depends on what y'all cook for Thanksgiving.
Well, when I say the traditional, meaning like some turkey, you know, mac and cheese and greens and
what y'all cook for Christmas? Who's coming over here?
I don't know. Honestly, we talked about it last night, trying to figure out what we're gonna do. Are we gonna go to Eaton or are we gonna stay up here? You know what I mean? I personally want to this year, like, do some, like, feeding, like, homeless.
Mm.
You know what I mean? Like, giving people, you know, doing stuff for people who may be in need. Mm. You know what I mean? Because, like, I ain't really into, like, the gift-giving and all that. But
yeah,
I do want to, you know, be a blessing to other people.
That's a fact. And that's what I think it's about. Like, you know, I just think people get Christmas so messed up. Like, because when I had kids, we not celebrating Christmas. Not like this.
Right, right.
Like, I don't believe in...
But you're going to put up lights, though.
Yeah, that's the thing. Yeah. So I guess I'm kind of... And I was thinking about that the other day, kind of like, girl, so do you celebrate Christmas or not? But remember working on that balance, not that all or nothing mentality. You feel me? So I'm working on myself.
Yeah.
But it's like, because I do, I love the lights, the Christmas, the excitement. I like the arts and crafts, the gingerbread man. I love doing shit like that with kids, but it's like, but we're not about to stress out about no gifts.
Yeah,
like, I get you shit all the time. Like, you get things all the time. So, I just don't believe in parents, like, even drilling that mentality into them. And I think, even if you're not drilling that mentality into them verbally, you going along
by
with
action.
Those actions is doing that. They seeing you go all out
working
for Christmas
crazy.
Knowing that your bills is not up to par. Like, what?
Yeah.
My kids ain't got to worry about it. And I'm telling them, they ain't even here. Ain't even thought of, but do not got to worry about that.
Right,
okay?
Because
And then it's like, why do kids shouldn't feel like they're a burden because their parent want to keep up with the lifestyle, go all out. You get what I'm saying? Because kids don't be asking for their parents to keep up with these trends.
Right.
So it's like, no. Because, you know, kids be like, you parents are saying stuff like, well, you can't do that. Christmas around the corner. What? I didn't ask for Christmas to be around the corner. I didn't ask for you to celebrate Christmas around the corner, Mom.
Right.
So, it's just annoying. I just really, like, parents piss me off the most around this time of the year. I ain't even going to hold it.
Okay, talk about it.
No,
not like something you get worked up. I like something you get worked up. Because
they just so simple. Yeah. It's really a simple thing. Yeah. Now, obviously, this is from my perspective, so don't be out there getting too angry. And if you is getting angry, then you just must be one of them simple parents.
Get in the comments and share it and tell people how mad you are about it. Okay.
Yeah, like, what do y'all get? I mean, I get it. I understand the thought of, you know, appreciating somebody and gifting them. But honestly, P, I do stuff like that when it's placed in my heart. Like, I do stuff for my friends, my family. I get them stuff all the time. I get it when I can, when I want to.
Right.
Not because of some, you know, like a man-made holiday. That's just... this time of the year, every year, that comes to break people's pockets.
Mm-hmm.
No.
Yeah. I mean,
I think the fuck not.
Right.
Like.
Well, skip all that. What are y'all gonna do for New Year? Like, people, come on, man. New Year is kind of like everyone is excited about New Year.
Yeah, no? I'm excited about New Year.
So what are you going to do? Like, what's the plan?
I think New Year's are so sacred.
Oh, okay.
I don't want to be doing too much.
Okay.
I mean, a new experience would be good, but as long as I'm in a good place mentally, let me see how I envision myself. Maybe like some, I was about to say coffee. I don't even drink coffee.
Well, you're about to be flued out for Christmas, right? So
that would be nice.
So... you know,
New Year's is more intimate, like, and not even on like, I guess more like a New Year resolution. Like, this, I'm like, bro, like, and then the older I get, it's like, yeah, dog, it's about to be a whole new year. Like, what is this gonna look like for me?
Mm.
Like, you know, I want to be on that type of time, so I probably honestly want to be by myself.
Okay,
yeah, I've been bringing a New Year by myself for like the past maybe 3 or 4 years anyway.
Really?
I be sleep, but this is like, I try to be more intentional to be up,
okay.
But, so at least I can give thanks and stuff, but
right.
I don't feel comfortable being out. And you gotta think other people out and about, they excited. Everybody displays their excitement in different ways.
Right.
My excitement is me
being in the house.
Yeah, with a candle. Get me a good candle and my little snuggy blanket. That's
it.
I'm excited. That's how I want my New Year's to go. That's how I want to bring in New Year's.
Well, I mean, I was expecting something different.
What? Who do you think
know.
I am?
I don't know. Like, I'm learning when I sit down with you.
Definitely different parts of me, too, though.
Yeah. Like, I wouldn't imagine you to be the, I just want to be alone on a quote-unquote festive night.
Mm. Yeah.
You know what I mean?
But then you got to understand, this is probably one of the most, I feel like one of the most sacred ones.
Hmm.
I mean, because everything else is, you know, man-made or stuff. But New Year, I mean, what's kind of... I just... I don't know. Like, even Thanksgiving, I was ready to be by myself until my friend was like, no, you should really come if your family not coming up here. But I'm way more of a homebody than what people think, I think. I think it confuses people because I'm so social. But energetically, it's like, yeah, keep me by myself.
So, you'd rather be home or would you rather have, like, to entertain people at your house? Like, yo, come over. You know what I mean? I'm hosting.
Mm-mm.
No.
Sometimes.
Right.
I may, like, you know, get in the mood, like, you know, y'all want to come over here, but it never works out like that. And then I think it never works out like that because I really don't want it to be like that. Because me, I'm a real... yeah, let's do it until it's time to do it. And not in all situations, but, like, in large crowds, it'd be like... because I get to thinking, like, no, nah, you don't know what this motherfucker got going on. And then I just get aggy. So it's like, yeah, before I read everybody in the room, let me just stay to my fucking self.
Mm.
Okay. So it just be kind of... okay.
Okay.
Yeah, y'all, I'm weird, I know. I love to socialize, but, like, home, energetic-wise, I need that home space.
Right.
Like, I need to be by myself.
Okay. So, I don't know.
What you thought I would have been doing? That would tell me a lot about how you think about me.
No, I just thought, you know, even if you weren't in, I don't see you as much of a partier. Is it a word?
Partier. I get what you say. It might be. It is now.
Don't y'all talk about my grammar, yo. Relax. But that much of a party person, But I would think that, you know, maybe a small crowd, you know, kind of like, you know, for Thanksgiving, what you did, like, you know, a few people that stood up, you know what I mean? Like, just chill.
And I do want to get there, too. And I think it's getting closer, like, that time for me to, like, you know, host and have gatherings. You just got to have the right friends. You got to have the right circle for stuff like that, too. And I'm getting there. I got some really, you know, dope people in my life. Right. So, shit, we there. We lit, y'all. We getting there.
Okay. So, what are we talking about next?
I don't know. You're going to ask a question from the bar.
So,
not you got a notepad over here with topics.
Yeah, I'm going. I just, you know, some things you can brush across.